Okay, assalamualaikum and hello. So this class is the last class for week one. Okay, week one, which is the effective or RMS value. So if you look at the note, okay, what is RMS or effective root mean square? RMS is a root mean square. So basically, it's the effective of the period current is the DC current that deliver the same average power to a resistor period current. Okay, so just ignore this. Okay. Okay, maybe we use the textbook, it's much more clear. Okay. Effective value is a periodic current is the DC current that deliver the same average current power to a resistor as the periodic current. So also confusing. Okay, no need to worry. Okay, so basically, effective value or RMS is basically the, when it comes to the AC, we use the RMS. Okay, if you look at the TNB, okay, let me show you. Okay, if you look at the TNB, the V supply is actually 230 right now. So volt. But the volt is actually in RMS. If you look at the, okay, this is time, this is voltage. If you look this, the peak is not 230, but it's actually 315, if not mistaken, or 25. Okay, so basically V RMS is equals to 1 over square root of 2 V peak. Okay. So this one. Okay. So V peak divided by square root of 2. That is RMS. So how to calculate V RMS is basically, let me check back. So this is the formula to calculate RMS. So basically, X RMS is equals to square root of 1 over t integrate 0 to t x squared. But when it comes to sinusoidal, okay, sinusoidal wave used by the AC, okay, the V RMS is automatically divided by square root of 2. This one, this formula. V RMS is equals to V peak divided by square root 2. Okay, this is only true for sinusoidal. Okay, if you have a different type of waveform, you have to use the formula. Okay, so let me show you. This is the formula. So how to use the formula? I think you don't need to consider too much because usually when it's come to AC, we have a sinusoidal wave, not this kind of wave. But if you have this kind of wave, you have to use the formula. You can see here, I is basically 5t from 2, 0 to 2. Okay, 0 to 2 is just a ramp. And then 2 to 4 is just a constant. So basically, you have to calculate 2, to integrate this. Okay, square it first and then integrate it and then square root it. Okay, this is how you determine the RMS value. Okay, when it comes to RMS, okay. Okay, if you use the period, okay, the integrate 1 over t, integrate the time, okay, you get the average like a power. But if in AC, you cannot get the answer, actually. Okay, for AC, you cannot, the sinusoidal wave, you get zero. That's why we use RMS, because it will show the effective value. Okay. So there is not too much on the effective value. If you want to understand it more, you can check it. But usually we are using the simplified formula. Okay, which is, where is it? Okay, this one. VRMS is equals to V peak divided by square root of 2. This is for sinusoidal. This is not sinusoidal. When it comes, when you don't have sinusoidal wave, you have to use the formula. Don't forget to square it. OK. Okay, don't forget to square it. And then let me show the formula back. Okay, so don't forget to square the formula, and then you have to square root all of it. Okay, and okay, this is the formula, of course, if you want to check. Okay, and another thing that you need to, okay, this one already explained. The RMS is 240. This one is the old TNB standard. Now it's 230. The peak value is much more higher. Okay. Okay. Be careful. For I think 225, 325 for peak. If it's 230, you can just use the calculator. Okay. So this one. Okay. Already. Yeah. This is repeated. Another thing that you need to consider is the power. Okay, so this one. Okay, remember that I said, where is it? Okay. Okay, if you use peak value, you have to divide by 2. But if you use RMS, you don't have to divide by 2. So make sure you be careful. If the question said that it is RMS value, make sure you don't divide by 2. Okay. If you they said it's the peak value, you divide by 2. Okay. Same here. If you use RMS, okay, you can see here the RMS, you don't have to divide by 2. Okay. If not, you have to divide by. Okay, this is the formula. I suggest you try to use the RMS. Okay, you can use this formula, much more easy. Okay, what else? Huh? Okay, this one, the RMS is much more easy. Okay. Okay, that's it on RMS, a simple topic. So thank you. See you next week.